Okay, so hold on, let me be sure we are doing the right one. Just hold on a little for me, so that we don't do stuff in. Okay, on this one. All right, so it's all good. So although the time spent on theoretical learning is much more compared to that spent acquiring practical skill, I think that both forms of learning require different times.
Please share your screen.
Oh, sorry. So here we are on the second paragraph. So your first paragraph is okay. So although the time spent on theoretical learning is much more compared to the spent, spent acquiring practical skill, I think it's to be in theoretical learning, not on in theoretical learning.
Okay.
Yeah. Spent acquiring practical skill, although the time spent in theoretical learning is much more compared to that spent acquiring practical skills, I think that both forms of learning, can we use something else instead of learning again? Why not knowledge acquisition? Okay, acquisition require different timelines. Timelines, it's talking about chronology of a particular event, chronology of events. So if you want to talk about timeline, you're talking about what happened around 9, 12, 3, 2, you know, that chronology. Chronological presentation of happenings. So that's what you call timeline. So the line is not supposed to be there. So different time, different period, different time, require different time. The knowledge acquisition, what forms of knowledge?
Can we use duration?
Isn't duration? Okay, duration is also useful.
Okay.
All right. In the early years of schooling, cognitive skills are gained from factual learning, which is what? There's something missing there. Proofreading. Cognitive are gained from factual learning, which is to acquire practical skills. Is that what you meant to say? Cognitive skills are required, gained from factual learning, which is to acquire practical skills. It still sounds awkward. So something is missing there. So what do you think?
Supposed to help in acquiring practical skills, so probably useful in.
The cognitive skills are gained from practical learning, which is useful for acquiring practical skills.
It will not be useful to again. It's required to enable them acquire practical learning. One is required to get theory first, then use it to acquire.
Okay.
So I think there was something I deleted there.
In the early years of schooling, cognitive skills are gained from factual learning, which is to acquire, which is
required.
Okay. Which is required. Required. Required to acquire practical skills. Since it takes a longer time to develop cognitive ability, children learn a lot of theory from the preschool age to the primary school and up to university level. By the time they begin to engage in practical learning, it could take them lesser time to acquire competence. Okay, furthermore, the level of competence acquired, furthermore, this level of competence acquired as a result of this pattern of teaching, this pattern of teaching students is likely to be of high quality. Okay. And this is likely to be high quality, and this is unlikely, and this is unlike the apprenticeship system where the trainee has no foundational knowledge of what processes are being carried out, where the trainee ends up engaging in. Okay, of what processes are being carried out, and then is that not shouldn't be then? Don't you think? And then the trainee ends up engaging in trial and error activities to obtain results. Hence, I strongly believe it is justifiable to allocate much more. I don't think I want that much more. Maybe. Much more could replace with a lot more. Or let's just remove the lot more gone. A higher amount of time to you allocate to you allocate for allocate to learning parts compared to practical learning. The practical learning facts compared to practical. I just leave it at practicals. And that both timelines are adequate enough to achieve the desired learning goal throughout all educational levels. Okay, let's see. Okay, hence I strongly believe that it is desirable to allocate a higher amount of time to learning facts compared to practicals and learning practicals, and that both timelines and that allotted time period to both are adequate enough to achieve the desired learning goals. Learning. I think we can just stay away from learning. Desired goals throughout all educational levels. In conclusion, this essay I think I prefer essay. Give reasons why I strongly disagree that the time spent on learning facts is too much, while that spent on acquiring practical skills is sufficient in all levels of education. Indeed, I believe that the timeline is again I don't want to use period, use time, use
What of time frame? I'm just brainstorming here too.
The time frame is better. At least it's not the same thing as timeline, nor is it timeline as time. Okay. Yes. It's just about being dexterous with your business as much as possible. Time frame for both learning methods are adequate enough to produce highly skilled professionals. So I'm going to detect this. Let's see whether you have your vital signs here. One. Okay, let's start from listen. Some people think that across all levels of system of the education, one, time spent, two, and in fact, three, wherever you have seen it, we will not use it again. It will not count wherever when you have used it before. So too much, if this is question device compared to is collocation and also comparison that relative to spending on that spent. Okay, they may perceive may is good because you did not, you left out overgeneralization. Perceive factual learning as a slow method of teaching children and a waste of valuable time. Valuable time is good there. Furthermore, it's good. They may be concerned that if too much time is spent on theoretical learning method, there may not be enough time for students to practice and become competent professionals after they graduate from the university. Competent professionals, good. Okay. For instance, which is this coercive advice, they may liken formal education to the apprenticeship system where relative clause, the trainee reads less and is taught less, but spends most of the time observing what relative clause the trainer does, and in a short while. Okay, let's see. Okay, in a short while they become they become as good as a teacher. Let's say they are here. Thus is good. These reasons may prompt the assumption that less time is being dedicated to practical learning than factual learning. Actual learning in all levels of education. So while it's also good there, although the time spent in theoretical learning is much more compared to that spent acquiring practical skills, I think that both forms of knowledge acquisition require different time. In the early years of schooling, cognitive skills are gained from factual learning. It's required to relative close, it's required to collocation, knowledge acquisition. I think I put that in there. So now let me just say this. You've seen it yourself that you need to work on your expanding your vocabulary. Okay, work on expanding your vocabulary. Try to stay away from repetition. Expand your vocabulary, repetition, proofreading. That's number three. And also I found out that there are some vital signs that are not there. I'm not sure in all of this there's any vital sign, any passive voice. There are collocations, there are contrasts. However, I'm expecting that you don't just go very monotonously. Although it's here, I'm expecting more coercive devices. Then it goes in early years of schooling cognitive. I want to see words like besides. Similarly, at the same time, in contrast to, you know, such words like that, so that it doesn't just go straight jacketed like that, straight monotonous. You have contrasted, you started with contrast, then what else again? Furthermore, you added the points, and there was no, let me see, let's, before I say that, compared to, okay, much more, I'm trying to hunt for positive advice now. I think the both acquisition require different times, like that. Okay, by the time, okay, so and up to this point. So I think, so you have this one here, then all of a sudden, this is one, two, and three out of a huge paragraph. So I think there should be more coming in. And I think you did more of compound sentences. There aren't very extensively long sentences. There are not many. For example, here now, you wrote from here up to this point, which is maybe one, okay, out of many. Look at that. Then here, just another one, another short one, do compound. Another one, compound. Then this one, it goes again. Okay, this one, let's see. Okay, this one is another extensively long one. But what about these two in between? Then you go from here and to here, which is good, but I'm expecting that you string very long sentences. If you can as well coin them together with your question device, it will make a lot more sense than, you know, listen. So you should do more with some of your what's the question devices so that they help to bring a lot of cohesion into your work. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. Or if you have any question, please.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Thank you, sir. I still have one question. The first paragraph.
Yes.
We talked about the introduction. We are supposed to introduce our paragraphs, right? The first paragraph. And you said the first paragraph is a repetition.
Well,
would there be a, could you give like an example so that?
Now the thing is the approach that I typically peddle is not the one you're using. So you know later on I asked what question maybe you if you follow the idea of people who will talk about the other side that you don't favor first, you know, and you said yes. Typically I don't go for that.
But I'm not talking of the pattern. Paragraph itself.
Okay.
Even if I have to swap it, how do I begin? How do I introduce that opposite point?
Okay, so certain people, first of all, it won't be certain people because that's what they said in the introduction. You won't repeat this. You know, this, do you agree that this first sentence is repetitive?
It's paraphrased. For me, it's paraphrase. At least I know it's not word for word.
Wait. Where is it typically needed that you should paraphrase? Is it not in the introduction? Mm-hmm.
Yes, so this is introducing the paragraph.
If you have paraphrased introduction and you are still paraphrasing your paraphraser in the body of the essay, is that what you're trying to say? You are paraphrasing your paraphraser again in the body of the essay.
Okay. That's what I'm asking for example.
Okay, good. Now you want to think of what is the typical reason why the people who say that learning facts, much time is learning is spent on learning facts. Okay. And then you want to put that in. So what is the reason? Why do you think that these people who are saying much time is spent on learning facts than on practicals? Okay. Why is the reason? What is the reason? Okay. Maybe you want to say that the reason for which people who think more time is spent on learning some historical facts compared to practical skills is that hardly from university to secondary school, a very little time is allotted, okay, or let's say the curriculum or timetable of most institutions shows the practical session of about 30 minutes once a week, something like that. That's the reason why they think, too much time is spent on learning facts and not enough on learning practical skills. Okay, maybe that is one. And you disagree, but you want to bring up the reason. This one is just a statement, but why would somebody say that? And they have probably taken a survey and found out that in in timetables of in the curriculum of most schools, okay, going from science to the arts to the social sciences, yeah, there is only one practical what's it called now timetable per week on the timetable. Or better still, in the departments of arts and humanities from secondary school to the university, practical skills is only exclusive to extracurricular activity where they probably just act drama, do debates, and such skills or such practical learning are not entrenched in the main school curriculum and activities, but in extracurricular activities. I hope you understand me. So that's the reason why they said too much time. Eh? So you bring that point, the points for which you think, listen, of course you said this, they may perceive factual learning as a slow method of teaching, teaching children and waste of valuable time. If that is the point that you are saying is the reason why somebody would think that more time is spent on factual learning, then it should be the very first thing that should be seen, not a paraphrasal. So I hope you understand.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So I don't know whether anybody has any question. Let's quickly look at this. Now, let me say this. If you have any question, please feel free to interrupt me. Now, this is a question. This is listening, right? Okay. Now, most people in the past who were taught by some very serious English teacher or some Ghanaians, if you are privileged to be taught by Ghanaians in secondary school, in primary school, or say even secondary school, like I was, you find out that some of this, you are tempted to write your first letter, the first letter of your word in capital letter, first letter of your answers in capital letter. If you do that, your answers will be wrong in the exam. And that is why some people tend to write severally because they don't know that fact. IELTS would mark you down if you write your first sentences, first letter of your answer in small letter, in capital letter, regardless of whether it is proper noun or a common noun. So most times, IELTS is expecting that you follow the rules of capitalization when it comes to writing names. So here, hostel is a name, but here, Buckley is, hostel is a common noun. Here is a proper noun. So it starts with capital letter. So then here is a code. It could go all through capital letter with the figures coming in where they should come. Then this is a proper, common noun. Then this and so on and so forth like that. Then here, common noun. But this S looks like capital letter to me. Common noun.
Look well, it's small letter.
Okay, I have my glasses on, you know, too. So let's compare this capital S, this S with this one. I hope you can see my cursor. Politics, S. And this S. So let's compare. Compare this.
You see small letter.
Compare this.
You see my B now in Buckley. See my B is very big.
Okay. Compare this. Let me just switch on this. The power company has struck again. So okay. Now, did I stop the video? Are you guys still there? Hello? option. Hello? Hello?